If you need to create a personalized calendar, or are just looking to include a calendar on a flyer, Swift Publisher is what you need. In this video, we're going to create this calendar. Let's get right to it. To get started, let's jump up to the toolbar and click the Calendar button. First, let's resize our calendar to fit our design and move it into place. An editor pops up once we double-click on any part of the calendar. Here we can change all of its properties. First, we can change the type of calendar. Next, we can choose a month and year, and then decide where and how they are shown. We can opt to display our days of the week to the top or bottom, and select the way each day is displayed. We can choose to show the full name, abbreviation, or just the first letter. Just below, we have a few different ways that we can place a grid between our dates to make them more readable. Lastly, weekends can be marked with color, and we can choose to either show or hide the days included in the previous and/or next month. So that's it for the content and format of our calendar. But what about the appearance? Calendar objects are basically split up into three parts that can be selected and edited separately: the dates, days of the week, and the header. When a section is selected, the text properties and background fill can easily be edited. In the Text tab, we can change the text size using the slider or these two buttons. Then we can change the color, as well as the font. Below that, we have buttons that change the alignment. Then, when we jump over to the Appearance tab, we can alter the background fill and the stroke. Let's uncheck both of those. That's basically it for editing the sections of our calendar. And with a little work, this is what we end up with. Looks great to me. So let's check out some of the other months. That's really all there is to it. So now you can mark events on your promotional materials or make a family calendar, all within Swift Publisher.